New Life in the UK Test Chapter 3. Test 9. Along an illustrious history, early Britain. The Middle Ages, the Tudors and Stuarts, a global power, the 20th century, Britain since 1945. You have 45 minutes to answer 24 multiple choice life in the UK test questions. You need to answer at least 18 out of 24 questions correctly to pass. Is the statement below true or false? In the Middle Ages, England's system of common law was established by referring to previous decisions and tradition. A. False. B. True. Correct answer, true. Explanation. This was also a time of development in the legal system. The principle that judges are independent of the government began to be established. In England, judges developed common law by a process of precedence, that is, following previous decisions and tradition. Henry VIII took which title in relation to Ireland? A. Commander. B. Head. C. King. D. Lieutenant. Correct answer, King. Explanation. During this period, Ireland was almost completely Catholic country. Henry VII and Henry VIII had extended English control outside the Pale and had established English authority over the whole country. Henry VIII took the title King of Ireland. On his escape from the Battle of Worcester, Charles II famously hid inside what? A. A cellar. B. A forest. C. An oak tree. D. None of the above. Correct answer, an oak tree. Explanation. Charles II escaped from Worcester, famously hiding in an oak tree on one occasion, and eventually fled to Europe. Parliament now controlled Scotland as well as England and Wales. Is the statement below true or false? Thanks to its position as the world's leading industrial nation during the 1800s, Britain was responsible for producing half of the world's coal, iron and cotton cloth. A. False. B. True. Correct answer, true. Explanation. British industry led the world in the 19th century. The UK produced more than half of the world's iron, coal and cotton cloth. The Royal Society was formed to promote what? A. Art. B. Astronomy. C. Music. D. Natural knowledge. Correct answer, natural knowledge. Explanation. Charles II was interested in science. During his reign, the Royal Society was formed to promote natural knowledge. This is the oldest surviving scientific society in the world. Which two events happened to the church in England following the restoration of Charles II? A. The Church of England was restored as the official church. B. The Church of England was suppressed. C. The Puritans and Roman Catholics were kept out of power. D. The Puritans grew in strength and number. Correct answer. The Church of England was restored as the official church and the Puritans and Roman Catholics were kept out of power. Explanation. Charles II made it clear that he had no wish to go on his travels, Argarin. He understood that he could not always do as he wished, but would sometimes need to reach agreement with Parliament. Generally, Parliament supported his policies. The Church of England again became the established official church. Both Roman Catholics and Puritans were kept out of power. Which of these statements is correct? A. During the 16th century, the Scottish Parliament abolished the authority of the Pope and Roman Catholic religious services became illegal. B. During the 16th century, the Scottish Parliament welcomed the authority of the Pope and Roman Catholics religious services became commonplace. Correct answer, during the 16th century. The Scottish Parliament abolished the authority of the Pope and Roman Catholic religious services became illegal. Explanation. Scotland had also been strongly influenced by Protestant ideas. In 1560, the predominantly Protestant Scottish Parliament abolished the authority of the Pope in Scotland and Roman Catholic religious services became illegal. How many people emigrated from the UK during Victoria's reign between 1853 and 1913? A. 100,000. B. 13 million. C. 2 million. D. 500 million. Correct answer, 13 million. Explanation. Many people were encouraged to leave the UK to settle overseas. Between 1853 and 1913, as many as 13 million British citizens left the country. Which statement describes party politics during the reign of William and Mary? A. There were two main groups, the Liberals and the Conservatives. B. There were two main groups, the Tories and the Whigs. Correct answer. There were two main groups, the Tories and the Whigs. Explanation. There were two main groups in Parliament, known as the Whigs and the Tories. The modern Conservative Party is still sometimes referred to as the Tories. This was the beginning of party politics. Is the statement below true or false? France was the first country to industrialize on a large scale. A. False. B. True. Correct answer. False. Explanation. The Industrial Revolution was the rapid development of industry in Britain in the 18th and 19th centuries. Britain was the first country to industrialize on a large scale. Which of these statements is correct? A. During the Great Depression of the 1930s, parts of the UK experienced mass unemployment. B. The UK experienced high levels of employment during the Great Depression of the 1930s. Correct answer. During the Great Depression of the 1930s, parts of the UK experienced mass unemployment. Explanation. In 1929, the world entered the Great Depression, and some parts of the UK suffered mass unemployment. The French Wars ended in 1815 when Napoleon was defeated by the Duke of Wellington at which battle? A. Battle of Naseby. B. Battle of Ostend. C. Battle of Trafalgar. D. Battle of Waterloo. Correct answer. Battle of Waterloo. Explanation. In 1815, the French Wars ended with the defeat of the Emperor Napoleon by the Duke of Wellington at the Battle of Waterloo. Wellington was known as the Iron Duke and later became Prime Minister. Which two events happened to the Church in England following the restoration of Charles II? A. The Church of England was restored as the official church. B. The Church of England was suppressed. C. The Puritans and Roman Catholics were kept out of power. D. The Puritans grew in strength and number. Correct answer. The Church of England was restored as the official church and the Puritans and Roman Catholics were kept out of power. Explanation. Charles II made it clear that he had no wish to go on his travels, Argarin. He understood that he could not always do as he wished, but would sometimes need to reach agreement with Parliament. Generally, Parliament supported his policies. The Church of England again became the established official church. Both Roman Catholics and Puritans were kept out of power. What are small Scottish farms also known as? A. Bothies. B. Crofts. C. Hamlets. D. Homesteads. Correct answer. Crofts. Explanation. A process began which became known as the Highland Clearances. Many Scottish landlords destroyed individual small farms known as crofts to make space for large flocks of sheep and cattle. In what way was Elizabeth I skilled at managing Parliament? A. She established a balance between Catholics and Protestants. B. She reduced the power of Parliament so her wishes had more significance. Correct answer. She established a balance between Catholics and Protestants. Explanation. Elizabeth did not ask about people's real beliefs. She succeeded in finding a balance between the views of Catholics and the more extreme Protestants. In this way, she avoided any serious religious conflict within England. Which of these statements is correct? A. Margaret Thatcher was the UK's first female Prime Minister. B. Margaret Thatcher was the UK's second female Prime Minister. Correct answer. Margaret Thatcher was the UK's first female Prime Minister. Explanation: Margaret Thatcher, Britain's first woman prime minister, led a conservative government from 1979 to 1990. The government made structural changes to the economy through the privatization of nationalized industries and imposed legal controls on trade union powers. Which of these statements is correct? A. Robert Burns wrote in Scots language. B. Robert Burns wrote in Scots, English, and a combination of both. Correct answer: Robert Burns wrote in Scots, English, and a combination of both. Explanation: Known in Scotland as the Bard, Robert Burns was a Scottish poet. He wrote in the Scots language, English, with some Scottish words and standard English. He also revised a lot of traditional folk songs by changing or adding lyrics. Burns' best-known work is probably the song Auld Lang Syne, which is sung by people in the UK and other countries when they are celebrating the New Year, or Hogmanay as it is called in Scotland. Which period of British history saw the emergence of a national culture and identity? A. The Bronze Age. B. The Middle Ages. C. The Tudor period. D. The Victorian period. Correct answer: the Middle Ages. Explanation: the Middle Ages saw the development of a national culture and identity. Richard Arkwright used steam engines to do what? A. All of the above. B. Create electricity. C. Power machinery. D. Pull carriages. Correct answer: power machinery. Explanation: later, he used the steam engine to power machinery. Arkwright is particularly remembered for the efficient and profitable way that he ran his factories. Who were the Huguenots? A. Dutch Protestants. B. French Catholics. C. French Protestants. D. Roman Catholics. Correct answer: French Protestants. Explanation: this was a time when many people left Britain and Ireland to settle in new colonies in America and elsewhere. But others came to live in Britain. The first Jews to come to Britain since the Middle Ages settled in London in 1656. Between 1680 and 1720, many refugees called Huguenots came from France. They were Protestants and had been persecuted for their religion. For much of the Stone Age, Britain was connected to the continent by what? A. A bridge. B. A glacier. C. A land bridge. D. A tunnel. Correct answer: a land bridge. Explanation: the first people to live in Britain were hunter-gatherers in what we call the Stone Age. For much of the Stone Age, Britain was connected to the continent by a land bridge. People came and went, following the herds of deer and horses which they hunted. Britain only became permanently separated from the continent by the Channel about 10,000 years ago. Where did the Boer War take place? A. England. B. France. C. South Africa. D. Turkey. Correct answer: South Africa. Explanation: the Boer War of 1899 to 1902 made the discussions about the future of the empire more urgent. The British went to war in South Africa with settlers from the Netherlands called the Boers. The Industrial Revolution saw the rapid growth of which of the following in the 18th and 19th centuries? A. Agriculture. B. Democracy. C. Industry. D. Population. Correct answer: industry. Explanation: the Industrial Revolution was the rapid development of industry in Britain in the 18th and 19th centuries. Which of these reasons best explains why town planning laws were tightened in the early 20th century? A. To allow for the building of new churches. B. To allow the further development of slums. C. To prevent the further development of slums. D. To stop skyscrapers being built. Correct answer: to prevent the further development of slums. Explanation: various laws were passed to improve safety in the workplace. Town planning rules were tightened to prevent the further development of slums. And better support was given to mothers and their children after divorce or separation.